Hey guys, how are you doing? Welcome to another episode of Ask Auntie. Somebody asked me this question on Twitter. They said, "Hey, I met somebody on Shaadi.com who seems really great. We get along just fine. We had like tons of things to talk about, but I'm a little concerned that this person has never lived away from family, and even right now he lives with his parents. I'm not sure I am okay living with in-laws after I get married. How do I actually ask him the question whether he's planning to move out or he wants to continue to stay with his parents?" I think that's a great question, and you're not alone. A lot of people have this question, and I think a lot of parents and maybe even guys sometimes judge this question from girls, and there's a tendency to sort of look at this the wrong way, where people feel like women are evil and they don't want to stay with their parents and so on. But let's be practical, right? Some of us have lived away from home, moved out for studies, and haven't lived with our own parents for the longest time, and we might not even be able to go back and live with our own parents, let alone someone else's parents. So I think your concerns are completely okay, and I'm pretty sure you don't have any doubts whether your concerns are okay or not. But I just wanted to say that it's okay that you want that, and it's okay for you to actually have to bring it up without fearing any sort of judgment. So rather than asking this other person what their plan is, which could seem like an intrusion of someone's sort of personal space if you haven't sort of gotten closer, what you could actually do is be clear on what you are actually looking for. You can sort of subtly hint, saying, "Hey, I've lived outside of home since I was 18, and I'm a fairly independent person. I like my space, I like my independence. I don't think I could, like, let's say, go and stay with my own parents right now. So when I get married, I do hope to sort of stay independently away from my parents and in-laws and have a sort of good distance, but also, like, let's say, be close to them." So I think it's okay when you say what you want, because then the onus is on the other person to tell you what their plan is. They're not going to hold it against you that you want them to sort of move away from their parents. They are going to appreciate your point of view, but at the same time also kind of open up about what their situation is. A lot of guys do stay with their parents with the plan to sort of move out once they get married. So it may not be evident in the beginning, but if you sort of bring up this conversation, they might tell you what the plan is. If at that point of time this person doesn't say anything and brushes past it, let them be, give them a little bit of space. Try and use the sort of comfort that you've built with this person to sort of explore other non-negotiables that you have in a relationship. See if this person brings other values that are important to you in the relationship. And once you see that there are other things that this person brings, and by that point of time you would have gotten a little bit more closer, then it's okay for you to be a bit more direct and say, "Hey, we're getting along great. I like how we vibe, and everything is great, but I'm a little bit concerned because you live with your parents, and I'm not sure what your plan is, whether you want to continue to live with them or you want to live independently. I feel like, hey, I'm not sure it'll be particularly easy for me to change my lifestyle too much, given that I live very independently. So I'm not particularly sort of thrilled about living with in-laws after I get married. Is this something that you would reconsider, or is this set in stone? Would you like to stay with your parents, or is staying close to them separately an option for you?" So you can bring that up, you can casually sort of bring that up and see what the other person has to say. Now, if they're sort of hell-bent on staying with their parents and that just doesn't work for you, then it's okay to cut your losses and move on, because what's important to you is important to you, right? If you don't feel like you want to negotiate on that bit, you don't have to. Now, when it becomes really hard is they're just perfect in every sense possible, and this is the only thing that's not working for you. In which case, you could consider how you can sort of meander around the situation, because if this person is important to you, what is important to them should also be important to you. But, you know, you will be able to take this call depending on how close you've gotten and how sort of important you are to each other. And I would imagine that this getting to this place takes at least about 6 months from meeting somebody, and this is not something you can decide in a month or two. So I hope this helps. Good luck and happy spouse hunting.